Hello, 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 you guys. This is just me saying a prolonged hello because I didn't know how long I'm going to narrate it. That's the reason I'm saying it's awkward hi for a really long time. But anyways, today we are going to do this beautiful, simple, soft, glam makeup look. Before we get started, I want to say there's no Indian and Western makeup look. You can wear this on any outfit. Of course, a little bit of kohl here and there does make a difference, but this makeup look, you can wear Indian, Western, anything, whatever you accessorize with is what makes the look complete. So anyways, I just first went in with moisturizer and now I'm using the e.l.f. Putty primer, and this is a really nice primer to fill your pores. I only used it around the nose, but I do have large pores. Then I'm going in with the Milani Conceal and Perfect Foundation. I really enjoy this foundation. It photographs really well. It's medium to full coverage. It looks very beautiful. It does not crease or transfer easily. It does stay on for a really long time. So I'm just taking a nice layer and applying it. Like always, I'm concentrating the maximum product on my cheeks where I do want to cover my acne scars. The shade does look a little lighter now, but it does oxidize and match up to my skin. You'll see that in some time. So I'm just applying it all over. Don't forget the neck. Next, I'm going in with concealer. So I'm going in with a lighter concealer, a little bit, which is the L'Oreal one, just to highlight and conceal perfectly. So I let that concealer stay there because I wanted it to dry down a little bit before I blend it out. That way I get a lot more coverage. So while the concealer is drying, I went in with my cream blush from Daughter Earth. Beautiful blush, such a beautiful shade. Can you see how well it blended and what beautiful color it gave to my skin? So I'm going in with a beauty blender and blending out the foundation. I'm taking my time to blend it properly. It's really important if you want a flawless base. Once I'm done with that, I'm going in with the brush which I used to, blend my foundation with, and I'm going over the edges there so that there's no harsh edges between the concealer, blush, and the foundation, and everything looks really nice and blended. Then I'm going in with the K Beauty powder and I'm going to just set the entire face with it. Next, I'm using the Wet n Wild contour powder and applying my contour wherever I naturally do. If you do want to see a video about that, I do have it. I'll link it above. You can check that out. I really like how soft this bronzer is and how well it blends into the skin. So I really like, using it. Like you can see, it just gave me a really nice subtle touch of color to my skin. So I'm going ahead and contouring my nose a little bit. Next, I'm going in with the Makeup Revolution blush and adding a tiny bit of it. Since I'm wearing purple, I'm going in with a pink blush. If you're wearing a warm toned outfit or something, then you can definitely go with corals or oranges. Next, for brows, I went in with the Benefit Precisely My Brow pencil. Trust me, this was a genuine mistake. It was not intentional. I was supposed to use a drugstore one. It just slipped out of my mind when I was doing brows and I went in with this. But a really good dupe for this is the NYX Microbrow Pencil, which I was actually supposed to use, but I don't know why I ended up using the Benefit one. So this is the only high-end product which I used. Rest everything is drugstore. Next, I'm going in again with the same L'Oreal concealer on my lids before I start doing my eyeshadow. Carving out your brows makes huge, huge difference. And I'm even going in with the brow mascara so that my brows just stay set throughout the event or whatever I'm doing. I'm using the Fay Beauty brush. It's a lash plus brow mascara. Next, I'm using the PAC All Matte Eyeshadow Palette and I'm adding a really soft transition shade. I went in with a warm shade because I wanted that to kind of match to a bronzer, so hence I used it. So if you don't have the shadow, you can literally go in with the bronzer you've used as well and create a dimension around the eye about where you want your eyeshadow to be. Then I went in with a deep pink and I'm now adding the color to my lids as I want it to be. I want it to be very, very subtle, so I just went in with one pink and I go ahead and further blend out the same pink with the first shade I already added, and I'm going to make it as soft as possible. It's super easy to do this eye look. Next, I'm just going in with a deeper shade and adding more definition on the outer edge. So first I, you know, kind of created a base of where I want my eyeshadow to be, and now I can intensify as much as I want. So I'm just going ahead and further blending it out. Then I'm going in with a shimmer shade from the Maybelline palette, and I'm going adding that on my entire lid. Really nice soft touch of shimmer. I don't really like glitters. I don't like the way they sit or blend, so I usually just prefer shimmers, and that's why I use this one. I was kind of feeling like there was a little bit of, you know, purple missing, so I took a Makeup Revolution eyeshadow palette and went ahead with purple. You really don't have to use so many palettes. It was my mistake that I did not, like, you know, choose the right palette. So, you know, you can choose one palette which has all these and you can, you know, get the job done. I'm going ahead and adding the shimmer again just to, you know, intensify it more. Next, I'm going in with the NYX Epic Ink Eyeliner. It's a really beautiful liner. It's felt tip and it gives such a precise application of liner. You can see how thin my wing looks, and I really love how long it stays as well. Then I'm going in with the Pack 53 lashes. These are really, really, really natural, so I love wearing it, especially for my eyes. I don't like a big lash, so this gives a very natural effect, but also, you know, makes your eyes look nice and full at the same time. So if you have tiny eyes like me, or basically like you don't have like a lot of lid space on top, you can go with these ones and they look really, really beautiful. I have a video on how to apply lashes. I'll link it here if you want to watch. Then I was trying to apply mascara and I got it on my bottom lash, which I later clean away with a Q-tip. But once I apply the lashes, I go in with the mascara and blend the, you know, false lashes with my real lashes, because you want it to look really nice and neat. You don't want there to be a separation between both of them, which is going to look very, very ugly. So then the part where I applied setting spray got cut off, but I went in with the e.l.f. setting spray and just spritzed it on my entire face. Next, I'm going in with the Lakme Iconic Kajal and I'm lining my lash line just so that there's no, like, you know, white line or something seen, and everything looks really nice thin black band. Next, I'm going in with the Maybelline Master Chrome highlighter. This is the shade Molten Gold. I'm just applying it. Remember to always blend in your highlighter. You don't want it to look like a line there. It just is supposed to give you the shine when light hits your face, when you see sideways. Next, I'm going in with the Women of Color Beauty lipstick, a really nice, beautiful pink, and that's it, you guys. I really, really, really loved how this look turned out. Once I accessorized, added my outfit, it just looked so, so beautiful. I wanted the look to be soft, but I actually wanted it to be glam as well. Like, I think this is the perfect balance between both of them. I love how it turned out. I even tried to experiment with a nose pin. I am not a huge fan, so I removed it in the rest of the footage. But if you actually liked it, or if you didn't like it, whatever you think, let me know in the comments. Nose pin or no nose pin. I also have the video of this entire outfit on my shorts, which I posted prior to this video. I also have this on Instagram if you want to watch. I love how that video turned out as well. And that's it, you guys. Thank you so much for watching. I really liked how this look turned out. And yeah, make sure like and subscribe to my channel if you like what I did here, and I'll see you guys in another video. Bye.